All right, so you're first, we're on the first Grunt in Space Center. I already have my team plan for all of Space Center, so for it. So for the first team, we want Urshifu, Beedrill, Gliscor, Empoleon. Already in my party, Seismitoad and Turtonator. First of all, we want to teach Aura Sphere for Urshifu. Coaching did not last very long, but whatever. Probably wasn't gonna keep it anyway, or even ever use it. All right, let's handle the scanner. We want no assault vest. We want leftovers. Citrus. Citrus. And charcoal, I think. Let me double check that. Yeah, that's all I need. No pre-damaging needed, right? Nope. Okay. So the Steelix is Bright Powder, Stealthrock's an explosion. Luckily, it can't explode turn one because Stealthrock has a higher priority than that. It can either Stealthrock, or it's a very low chance to attack. I would like it to Stealthrock here. If it attacks, we can manage it. So we're gonna have to change up the line a bit. So Aura Sphere always hits for the Bright Powder. Yeah, just rocks. It's fine. We've accounted for that. Appleton comes in because it's the only thing that sees kill, a slow kill. We go into Beach Drill. It's Apple Acid guaranteed. We take that even after the Stealth Rock's damage because we four times resist it. Could have also Leech Seed it, but that's fine too. Oh, thanks for the follow, Brisson. So we Mega Evolve it, you turn out. This kills it. We go into Gliscor on this. This should bait in Simisear for Hidden Power Ice. Yep. It can't. This has Focus Command. It can't Nasty Plot though because it sees that I have a kill on it with Earthquake, so we can safely switch into Empoleon on the Hidden Power Ice. So we can use this chance to defog away the rocks. It's not gonna be able to set up either because it has, I guess I have a kill on it with Surf. We surf this. It's gonna need to get like three focus bait procs in a row. And we have backups in case that happens too. Alright. This is gonna be in Zipstrika. Yep. This Zipstriker is also Focus Band, but with the combination of Sizotoad and Gliscor, we should basically always beat this. Barring some like really crazy bad luck. Okay. Corviknight comes out. We beat this. Tornadus a pretty good answer to this, though. It doesn't really care if it sets up. It always kills with Charcoal Overheat. Takes barely any damage from its moves. Yep, see. That was weakness policy, so it was important that we got that one shot. I think you can technically fight Grunt Free first if you wanted to for some reason. Like that. Alright, that's one for Urshifu. And for Beedrill. One for Empoleon, one for Seismitoad, and one for Turtonator. Okay, so next Grunt. This has a full team of six, but I think I have a riskless plan for it, assuming I didn't mess anything up. Okay, so for this we want Beedrill. Mitchell's already in my party. Aggron. Gallicipod. Oh no, Dragapult's before Gallicipod. Where is my Dragapult? There it is. And Empoleon and Shifu, which is already there. Alright, so need to just set up a few things for this fight. Well, okay. Go to Marvel. I need to teach Brick Break to Empoleon. I also need to go grab the Choice Scarf. Beedrill is Megastone. Aggron wants no item. Dragapult wants Life Orb. Not Flame Orb. That would. Gallicipod wants no item as well. Empoleon wants Citrus. And Shifu wants Choice Scarf. No, not Flame Orb again. So, yeah, we also need to do some pre-damaging, let's get the script out. So I need Aggron to be at 148 HP. And Gallicipod needs to be at 175. Double check I have this right. Yep, we're good. Double check items. Beedrill 8. Life Orb, none. Citrus, Choice Scarf. And Scarf Shifu outspeeds what I need it to. Yep. Yeah, the Scrafty's gonna intimidate us, that's fine though. The Scrafty is always clicking Stone Edge this turn on my Beedrill. Knockoff doesn't kill because Mega. So we U-turn out first. After Mega evolving. Alright, we go into Aggron on the Stone Edge. Doesn't do a lot to us, because well, we're in Aggron. So this is going to be guaranteed close combat. We go back into Beedrill on that. It does have... That's fine, we have counted for that. So after the close combat drops, this U-turn always kills. So we go back into Aggron. This is going to be fast kill from Duraludon, and we're pre-damaged specifically to be dead to body press from this. Because it sees fast kill, it isn't going to be able to set up Stealth Rocks. So we can go into Dragapult safely on the Body Slam. Okay. So Draco Meteor with the Life Orb boost always kills, even though it's not super effective against Steel type. Duraludon has bad enough special defense that this still kills anyway. So after the Life Orb chip, this is going to bait in specifically Weavile for slow kill with Night Slash. Wait, what? Oh no, they're the highest roll of two-hit Dragon Darts kills Weavile. I had completely missed that in planning. I should have gone Dragon Fang instead. I didn't need the Life Orb boost. That was... Alright, okay, how am I gonna get around this? Okay, at the very least, can this not set up Dragon Dance? It can't because I have fast two-shot with... Okay, I think I can... I might still be able to get around this. No, wait, this actually messes up the whole line. If I go Urshifu to kill this, which was the plan, then it will bait in Exeggutor. Okay, I might. There might be a way I can get around this. If I can kill this Aerodactyl with Pult, Exeggutor sees that it's. Oh wait, no, actually everything on the team sees that it's fast killed by Pult, so it will still go Exeggutor anyway. Wait, maybe not. Darmanitan wouldn't if I drop my special attack with Meteor. That doesn't really help me though, because. Shoot. Okay, this is actually so bad. How the heck am I even gonna get out of this? Okay. I have a potential idea. If I can take enough damage with Shifu, I could potentially bait Weavile low kick in. And that would recover the line, but. But then how am I handling the Darmanitan after? That's. Because the positioning will be completely messed up. Is it gonna be that I might just have to risk Beedrill on Quick Claw Eggie? Maybe Pult instead on Quick Claw Eggie. My range to kill Darmanitan with Pult is incredibly bad. Can I, like, at least do anything of guaranteed Flare Blitz? Golisopod takes too much to eject from that. Wait, wait, wait. No, that won't work. I think I might have to just do the stain of Beedrill angle. This is gonna be so scuffed. Alright. How much is an earthquake doing to Shifu? Not too much. Are we going into Aggron and dual wing beat? And put me in low kick range this turn, please. Okay, that should be low kick range. Damn it, it's just barely out of it. But the problem is that I'm dead to Earthquake crit now. Oh god. Could I? No, that won't work. I just have to kill here. Galissapod takes too much damage, and even if it doesn't, it's dead to crit, and even if it doesn't die, it just gets ejected out. I kind of have to go it though, that's the thing. Come on, don't get crit. Okay. If we go Pult here. Split, the Archie splits. If I go Dragapult, that would just be in Dermanitan, then I lose. No, wait a second. No, wait, I'm just barely in range of it. I think I have to go Beedrill and just hope it doesn't quick claw. If I can kill this with Beedrill, I could go into Urshifu. Wait a second. Oh wait, I didn't consider something. It wouldn't have been Weavile anyway because I'm Scarf, so I outspeed. That was just completely unnecessary. Oh god, I'm misplaying this so badly. This means that if I... So this does mean that if I kill... If Beedrill U-turn, this AU of Beedrill U-turn, I can go into Shifu. It will see that both mons are fast killed by my Dermanitan, so by my Shifu, so we'll go Dermanitan, liquidation it, and then Weavile comes in for low kick. I think that's like this is the only way I can handle this. Alright. Come on, don't quick claw. Please don't quick claw. Okay, good. Okay, we go into her Shifu. Yep. Liquidation to kill. This Weavile's bright power, so we're gonna have to play around this. Okay, let me look at this. So, what? It's going to be guaranteed to click low kick this turn. Can my Beedrill take two low kick crits? Yeah, it can. So, and Beedrill, once it comes in, it's always going to be clicking Ice Shard because it's a priority move that it sees kill with. So we can go into Empoleon on that. Okay. Yep, this works. Wait. Oh, no. It's going to... Shoot, it's going to... There's a chance it can Ice Shard here because it sees the eye fast kill it. I got a good thing I remember that. That would have been disastrous. But there's a chance it can still just click low kick anyway. Because it sees a kill? Wait. Oh, no, wait. It doesn't see a kill with low kick. That's right, because we did the... Okay, so this is actually guaranteed Ice Shard. Wait. Wait, does it see that I'm locked into liquidation? Oh, I don't actually know. That's... Okay. Apparently, AI does see that your choice locked into a move when it's on the field. It wasn't for Switch, and I know that, but... My Shifu does have Aura Sphere. So if... Okay, I think... this. Okay, I have an idea. Shifu is not dead to double ice shard crit, is it? No, it's not. So, because I don't know how this is gonna work, so I'm gonna go into Empoleon. Empoleon will always bait low kick after I go into Beedrill. Beedrill will always bait it to ice shard. I go back into Urshifu with Scarf. I outspeed an Aura Spirit. Okay, it does see that I'm locked in. So go into Beedrill on the guaranteed low kick. Okay, now it's always Ice Shard because it sees kill with priority move and I'm faster. Ice Shard will never kill us. We can Aura Sphere to take it out. Oh, Jesus Christ, that was an insane steer. The fact I managed to actually get out of that deathless, I don't even know how I managed to do that. I mean, it was because it didn't hit the quick claw on Eggie. Okay, so that's okay because of the steer line. Like, I'm really changes the frags as well. That's free for Shifu instead. One, two for Beedrill, and one for Pult. Okay. So for this one, first get the Choice Scarf off Shifu. Yeah, okay, so we want Aggron to the lead. Salazzle. Arcanine. Turtonator. Dragonite. And Empoleon. Right, so let's go. Yeah, we want specs. Give it to Salazzle. We want the Megastone on Aggron for this. Hamilton. Citrus. Zoomlins. Lum. And Empoleon is Citrus. We also want to teach Empoleon back Surf. And Dragonite, we want to teach Aerial Ace. Empoleon can learn Aerial Ace, I didn't actually know that. No pre-damaging needed, nope. Actually, I should pre-burn Salazzle. Again, it is possible to do this legitimately, despite Salazzle being a fire type, by getting soaked and then Flame Orb activating. Just to double check this. Yeah. So this Diggersby is Quick Claw, huge power. It's insanely difficult to deal with this thing, but I have one of the better counters to it. This sees a very nice target against the Aggron with Earthquake, but what it doesn't know is that I'm about to Mega Evolve, lose my Rock Typing, so I'm only one, two times weak to Earthquake, and gain Filter, so I can then live the Earthquake crit, and kill this with Body Slam. Usually there is, this is a potential range to kill, but it's fine if it doesn't, because I have a plan if it doesn't kill. My Aggron isn't very good yet. Quick Claw is perfectly fine. We're slower anyway, so unless Quick Claw like somehow goes before Mega Evolution, which it doesn't. Okay, we do get the kill. This should bait in Silvally. Yeah. Going for Flamethrower. We can switch into Salazzle on that. We take Flamethrower. With Choice Specs, we always kill with Flamethrower. Okay, so Arcanine comes out. That's fine. We go into Turtonator on this. Would like this to not paralyze, ideally. Alright. So this is gonna close combat, and we Draco after that. We can hit, we always hit this because it zoom lines. This thing's bright powder. Alright. So now we go into Dragonite on the close combat. We can always take Wild Charge crit after this. We have Lum in case of paralysis and Aerial Ace to kill it. We should ban Ribombee for Moonblast? Or is it Dazzling Gleam? I can't remember which one this has. Yeah, Moonblast. Okay. Hamilton hard walls this Ribombee. It does like no damage to it at all. It's focus ban, but we need to get like 10 in a row to kill me, so. Maybe we'd have to get less if it crits me enough times, but. We don't care about special attack drops because we're physical attacker. I probably should have gone for Flare Blitz instead, whatever. And then last up is Kling Klang. This thing has only Gear Grind. We go into Empoleon. We four times resist it, so it doesn't do much to us. And we just eventually kill this with Surf. Gear Grind, I thought that Gear Grind could flinch for a long time, but apparently it can't. If it crit every single one, we would still survive. Alright, so that's one for Aggron. One for Salazzle. It's been a while since Salazzle's gotten one. One for Arcanine. One for Dragonite and one for Empoleon. Okay, so just to make sure I don't mess this up again, I want to check my ranges with Pulse. I'm not running Life Orb on this fight, so need to worry about that as much. Yeah, we're good. Okay. So for this we want, this is Courtney for reference, one of the admins, so Beedrill, Berserker. We don't actually need the scanner item for this fight, kind of crazily. Dragapult. Azumarill. Urshifu's finally only coming as a pivot. And Gliscor. Beedrill Megastone. We want Citrus on Berserker. Dragapult actually wants no item. Azumarill, Citrus, Urshifu, Citrus, and Gliscor, Citrus. Did I get that right? Oh no, Azumarill actually wants Lum. I should just go Aspear instead. It's unnecessary to run Lum. I'm pretty sure it is. Yeah, Buzzwole can only freeze me. Okay, so we want to. This is gonna be kind of weird, but we're gonna pre-burn Gliscor. There is a specific reason we're doing this. We also need to do some pre-damaging. Berserker needs to go to 198 HP, and Dragapult needs to go to 148. Quickly double check something. Yeah. All right, that's all we need. 198 is enough HP, right? Zard X doesn't have, Zard doesn't have Tough Claws in base form. 148, I meant to say, but yeah, that is what I am at. So leads off with Shaymin. Beedrill, my Beedrill's crazy enough that it happens that I one-shot this with Leech Life. Just like full one-shot this from full HP. Okay, so Dugtrio sees that it's fast killed by my Beedrill, so it will go into Tyrantrum because it's the first thing that has a slow kill. It has it with both Head Smash and Scale Shot. We U-turn on it. We go into Berserker, important pivot. If it scale shots, that's actually fine. It can take either move it goes for, and it's always going to be baiting close combat after. I made sure to pre-damage so that I'm not sure if this is actually true, but like just in case that there's some like weird AI where it can scale shot over highest damage because it could technically maybe be considered a setup move. I don't know if it actually works like this, but in the event it does, I pre-damage to make sure that we're always dead to scale shot, even if Head Smash missed. So we'll always be, and then not scale shot, we're always dead to close combat. Even if it's scale shotted, Dragapult is still faster than this. So we go into Dragapult on the guaranteed close combat. Okay, so we just killed this as Draco Meteor. So Zerkatree doesn't see a kill on me. So the first thing that sees a slow kill on me is Buzzswole with Ice Punch. So we go into Azu on the Ice Punch. To set up this kill correctly, I want to specifically Draining Kiss once and then Fake Tears. It's gonna Stone Edge. That's fine, we can take that. Now we Fake Tears. That's fine. We never did a crit there. We had Citrus Berry in case it crit the first time for reference. So now it's going to Stone Edge here. We go into Urshifu on that. Now it's always going to be Drain Punch, so we have a safe switch back into Dragapult. So we can now, after the chip damage from Drain Kiss and the Fake Tears Spideff drop, we always kill this with Flamethrower. And the good thing about this setup is that the next thing that sees a slow kill is Charizard with Dragon Claw because of the specific HP I pre-damaged to. But what Courtney doesn't realize is that it's good that she's gonna be dumb and Mega Evolve, turn Charizard into a Dragon type, and then die to Draco Meteor. Yeah, good job, Courtney. So the next thing that comes is Zerkatree because Dugtrio's minus one because I have a fast kill on it. So we go into Gliscor on the guaranteed Thunder. Well, it's not actually guaranteed. It can Hypnosis or Sub, but that's also fine if it does that. So basically, the idea with this is we want to just keep pivoting between this and Beedrill until we can kill this with Beedrill, either U-turn or Leech Life. It doesn't matter what I kill it with. This is always going to be baiting in. We're burned to prevent hypnosis, so we'll just grass knot. Yep, we U-turn first. This can kill with crit. If it does, though, we just go to Dragapult to take out the Dugtrio. So we go back into Gliscor here. It's going to either Thunderbolt or Hypnosis. Maybe I might sub. That's fine, though. Yep. So, now we just Leech Life. And now Dugtrio is last, which is just fast killed by Beedrill U-turn. U-turn does kill, right? I'm almost certain it does, yeah. This Dugtrio has, like, no defense whatsoever. So that's 3 for Beedrill and 3 for Pulp. That's yeah, it's kind of funny that that's the distribution that ended up happening. Alright, next up is a 3-grunt gauntlet. This one's pretty easy, though. I'm gonna say that, and then I'm gonna have turned out to have messed something up. But there is something that can go wrong, potentially, though it's pretty unlikely. I don't think we ever wipe. So it's Urshifu. Seismitoad. Gliscor. Arcanine. Yeah, okay, so get Gliscor, Arcanine, Empoleon, and Azu. So we want Metal Coat on Urshifu. Seismitoad wants Lum. Gliscor wants Persim. Hamilton Citrus. You want Rost and you Citrus. All right. And we also need to teach Smart Strike to Urshifu. I mean, Orisfear, you did clutch up quite a bit in the on the Weavile, but yeah, I have to get rid of you for this. Yeah, that's all I need to do. Yep, okay. Double check something. Yeah, okay. Yes. What happens if you say no, but whatever, I can't test it now. So this Armaldo is just. This Armaldo is Bright Powder, but with Metal Coat, Smart Strike is always going to 2-hit KO. We can take anything that goes for crit. It's perfect, all perfectly fine. That's perfectly fine. We take this. It's gonna be Rotom will be the only mon left. We go. It's gonna be Thunderbolt or Will-O-Wisp. We go into Seismitoad on that. Just double surf to take it out. We can take any hit this goes for. Multiple hits, multiple crits. It's all perfectly fine. That's fine. Lum was unnecessary there, but whatever. Machamp. So this Machamp is always clicking Dynamic Punch. It won't click Bulk Up because I have a fast 2-hit KO on it, so we can go into Gliscor. The Dynamic Punch is guaranteed to hit and confuse, so we will always use up our Persim Berry, which is good because we want Acro to do the most amount of damage. This is always going to be Stone Edge again. Are we dead to Stone Edge crit? If I'm dead to Stone Edge crit, I need to go into Urshifu to kill this with Aqua Jet, because this is Quick Claw Machamp. We're just not dead. Talonflame comes out, Arcanine like just beats this easily. It doesn't matter what it does, it's just always going to beat it. Even if it like Swords Dances and then Acro crits, which it wouldn't have been able to there, but it could have been able to if Gliscor was high enough HP. It still would have beaten it. Alright, so this Bisharp's pretty easy. We just close combat it and take it out. We're faster than it. Just it always dies because it's four times a week. No weird items. It's just Lum. So with this, yeah, this is weeding because we have a potential kill on Guzzlord, so Napoleon can just easily take this weeding out. It does almost no damage to us. Yep, and then the last up is the Guzzlord, Focus Band Guzzlord. Things could potentially get very wrong, go a bit wrong against this if I get really unlucky, but it's incredibly unlikely it will. So we go into Gliscor, I think. It's at 56 HP, so there is a chance I can just click the bad moves anyway. Didn't fully think about that. Would Urshifu work? I wanna like try and bait Guaranteed Dragon Rush. Yeah, Urshifu would work. It's always clicking Earthquake against Empoleon. Yep, there's no overlap. So now we go into Azu. Guzzlord is incredibly slow, and my Azu happens to have enough speed to outspeed this. So to get like the ideal recovery, we're gonna want to fake tears first, and then Draining Kiss. Hopefully Focus Band just doesn't proc. Alright. Okay, so that's two for Urshifu, one for Seismitoad, one for Gliscor. Where's my, oh, there it is. One for Arcanine, one for Empoleon, and one for Azu. Right, so now it's time for space tag. My space tag line is mostly safe. There's like one potential thing that could go wrong. It's like incredibly fiction, though. I couldn't find any better angle. It's also going to require sacking three to it, so it's. I mean, two of the mons are pretty useless at this point, but. The other one's going to sting more as a loss, which is, yeah, Conkeldurr. I have Urshifu now, so Conkeldurr isn't the worst thing to lose. It's also minus. Mine is also minus attack, so it's less good, but yeah, it's still not ideal. But I just couldn't find another way. And Octillery is the last one. I need to get my scanner item back. Who has it right now? I guess it must be in my bag. Oh wait, actually, I don't think I need to trade it for anything, because I think it's the spec still. Yeah, it is. Okay, something I do need to do, though, is teach Conkeldurr Ice Punch. So, Kecleon wants to hold Life Orb, and Artillery wants specs. Conkeldurr doesn't actually want an item. We want to pre-burn Conk. I like the good thing. Don't make the same mistake I made of Hariyama, because if I do, I just straight up wipe. If it's not pre-burned. Alright, we also need to do some pre-damaging, a lot of pre-damaging. My whole Tauri is going to be pre-damaged, which means it's only three mons, so it's. Fifty-four, 140, 54, and 178. Sandstorm damage is 6.8, right? Yeah, 116. So that's. Yeah, so that is 6. Okay. All right, let's do it. All right, let's do it. Okay, so this is like the classic tag lead. So Dialga wants to set up Trick Room, but the other side is trying to prevent it from doing so. Tyranitar by taunting it, and Landorus by just killing it with Earth Power. So we lead off with Kecleon fake out to prevent the Landorus from moving, and we are pre-damaged so that Tyranitar in base form always sees a kill on Kecleon, so it will not taunt the Dialga. So Dialga gets a Trick Room. It is very important. We need Trick Room to be able to win. And the fake out damage on Landorus is very important, which is actually why we went Life Orb. By Kecleon. It's gonna Trick Room. Yep, okay. So after the fake out damage, and since Dialga has a Dragon Gem, it's always going to see a kill on Landorus, so we go into Conk here. With Trick Room, we're both faster. We Hammer Room to kill the Tyranitar, and Dialga will always target the Landorus with Dragon Pulse to kill it. If I did this calcing correctly, Conkeldurr shouldn't be dead here to the combo of Burn slash Sand. Yep, okay. The reason why we've pre-damaged Conk so much is that I need Conk to die this turn specifically. It's going to be going into Heatran and Moltres, because it sees, since it uses the Dragon Gem, Moltres sees itself as out-damaging Dialga, but Moltres is always going to be targeting my Conkeldurr since he's a kill on it. So we need to Hammer Arm the Heatran to kill it. This is where the potential risk in the fight comes. So Dialga is going to be either targeting Moltres with Dragon Pulse or Heatran with Aura Sphere because it sees highest damage. The attack is always going to go into Moltres because Heatran's going to die before, since my Conkeldurr is slower than Dialga. So if this like it's like two the two highest rolls of crit and Dragon Pulse on Moltres, then it will die to Sandform, which is incredibly bad because Ferroform will be out before we want it to be. It's like 50-50 high roll crit, like that's complete fiction to happen. So we Hammer Arm Heatran to kill it. I'm actually in a superpower just to style on him. So since in case Moltres misses Hurricane, Conkeldurr still dies to residual. Come on, don't super high roll crit. Okay, good. Alright, we're always good, we're always safe then. 07 Conk, you were amazing. Okay, now we go into Octillery. We have the choice specs on Octillery. We're pre-damaged so that both Garchomp and Moltres, Garchomp in base form and Moltres, always see kills into Octillery so neither of them can protect. So we're gonna Water Spout. It's gonna take out Moltres, even like even if it Aura Sphered, it would in Mineral, it would still have killed after it's killed. And it's gonna do enough damage to Garchomp that Dialga can take out with Dragon Pulse. Since Dragon Pulse is the highest damage on both Moltres and Garchomp, it will always click that. And since we're slower, then Dialga will always move first. Since we're faster under Trick Room. Ferroform is going to kill our Octillery with Power Whip unless it misses, but Dialga is going to take out the Ferroform with Flamethrower, so we win. And that's the victory. Alright. Kecleon, you did a great job. You got us the leftovers on TNL, did some stuff for out. I'm gonna miss you. Konk, I will admit the minus attack has been rough, but you have still been putting in a lot of work. I've definitely been happy with your performance. Octillery, you honestly haven't been doing a lot, but hey, you got what's what we needed here, and you did get us a dupe for Galissapod, so I'm not gonna complain. Let's update the frag counter. So that would be 0 for Kecleon, 2 for Konk, And one for artillery. Steven got a lot of kills, so we're not actually getting a lot of frags for us. And also mark those guys as dead. Alright, now we have access to dive. Steelix, well, I don't have a Steelix, but thanks anyway. So we're gonna get 124 dive encounter. There's a few stuff we can get. We can get Armaldo, Cradily, Cavitas, or Delmise. Yeah, I actually did sack 3 on Space Tag. It was on purpose. It provided me the safest line, so I just did it. These are the 3 that died on Space Tag. Thanks. Yeah, okay, so what do I want to like bring for this? Probably like Empoleon, maybe not Aggron, Dragon, no, Gudra's probably good. Slowbro. Gliscor. Oh my gosh, for like the Cradily. Oh, the Delmise, I think we actually need to be very careful about because. Oh no, this doesn't have Anchor Shot, so it's actually a lot less scary. And yeah, let's bring. I don't know, I guess Legion. Actually, Amoongus is probably good for this. Let's bring that. Doesn't like matter a ton what we get here. I think I would like prefer Armaldo the most. Getting another Battle Armormon would be nice. Omastar would, Kabutops would also probably be good too. Omastar is on the other diving route. That's not, it doesn't take us to grass. Oops. Alright, just, okay. Let's take a look at this. Be careful of this one. So, these optionals have just level up sets, so. This thing does have explosion. That's a tad annoying. I don't think it, I mean, we're like, several levels above it shouldn't kill us. That's Misty Explosion. Yeah, it doesn't kill us. No, we don't also kill it. Maybe Gudra would be better to handle this one. Explosion actually does a lot to us. It's gonna likely explode here. Beresquita. This one is high enough level that it has flip turn, so it shouldn't be able to touch my Slowbro. That's not what I'm supposed to look at. Yeah. Okay, and his own Slowbro. We can probably just go like Eldegoss on that. All right. Mean, it could have gotten worse, but we're good. Let me just make sure to watch out. Where the heck is the do I go to get the okay. See what we end up getting. Kabutops. Okay, that's interesting. I definitely don't mind getting this. This is gonna be a bit of a pain to catch because it is a fossil, so it's that's a really low catch rate. I should be able to stay in one more turn. Okay, yeah, I should switch out now. How does Gudra take this on? It's what level is it? 75? Yeah, it's not the best, but oh wait, that's a level 100 one. Yeah, we actually take it pretty well. Okay, it should be in timer ball range soon. Okay, we got it now. I believe that this thing gets protect. Oh no, it doesn't. That's Omastar. Wait, does it? I was looking at the wrong set. Nah, it doesn't. Okay. I mean, it does get Rapid Spin though. That's decent. It's unfortunately we miss out on Rock Slide because of when we get it, but yeah, it's not the end of the world. Does either Battle Armor or Swift Swim? Obviously I would prefer Battle Armor. Swift Swim doesn't seem like the worst I could get, though. It's been decently fast. Okay, we did get Swift Swim Naive. This is like near max speed. Free attack, though. It's probably isn't gonna be the most useful, but it could be a lot worse. I mean, if nothing else, it provides nice warm body. I missed the last two shell armor rolls, but I mean, considering how many I won early game, I guess it's probably fair that I do. Realize Electro still had that. I do also have to deposit my two the three mons that are dead from the calc. Where is my artillery in here? Oh, there it is. The box isn't as like big as I would want it to be, but we do have a decently good quality of guys. Almost everyone I've got here is extremely good. Except for, like, Siding Toad's kind of meh at this point. Dreadnought's whatever. Starmie's not the best. And we got more encounters to pick up, so I definitely am still think that this run's in a pretty good place. Alright, who's live for me to raid? And no one really, it's a bit late, I guess. Okay, I'll just end then.